We're definitely not taking anything for granted. We're not even expecting them to play in a certain manner. We just want to focus on our skills and the things that we need to do right, because us as a side, we're looking forward to correcting the things that haven't gone right in the last two tours that have been on. So our focus is purely on our team.
It's been a very impressive, successful year for your fast bowlers away from home. But historically, Indian fast bowlers come into wickets on these pitches. After two tours of Australia, have you figured out what your bowlers need to take wickets, and do you think this effect can do that?
I think it's pretty different from the last time we came here. There's much more experience. The guys are much more fitter than they were last time when we came here. So I think in Australia, the key is to keep bowling in good areas for longer periods of time. And the conditions also become hard because it can get really hot. And the pitches can be flat purely because of the Kookaburra not doing much after 20-odd overs until, you know, it reverses around 45-50. That middle phase is very, very crucial. So we've identified those things, and the guys themselves feel that they are at the peak of their skill levels at the moment, and they're looking forward to this challenge. You know, we don't want to be in a situation where we're looking for ideal bowling conditions or ideal batting conditions. So the bowlers are in a mindset where, you know, whatever the situation might be or however hard it might be, they're looking forward to performing in those conditions and doing what the team wants at the end of the day. No one's, you know, going to go out there gunning for a 6-wicket haul themselves. If it takes 8 good overs in a spot and getting a wicket for the team, they're ready to do that. So I think that mindset is very crucial, and that feedback is coming from the bowlers themselves. So it's not been told to them. They are talking about all these things, which I think is a very positive sign.
Virat,
happy hunting ground for you personally. After scoring a time in England, you said the one in Adelaide still is your favourite. Happy to be back.
Yeah, I love coming to this ground, the city in general. I really enjoy the city. I don't know what the connection is, but I just feel really good here. And not to say that, you know, performances are always guaranteed in a certain place, but yeah, coming to Adelaide, I feel different from any other place that I've gone in the world, and that's just been the case. And it happens to every cricketer. They do have a favorite sort of ground away from home, and for me, Adelaide always has been special, because I scored my first test done here. So from then on, the connection started. But yeah, it's a great place to play cricket in general. I mean, the stadium's been redone. The pitch has always been good. So it's about which team plays better. It's that kind of a wicket. You know, there are no givens on the Adelaide pitch. And yeah, I've enjoyed my cricket here.
Okay, sir. Your third test on Australia, you had so many other batsmen who have been here and have played test cricket. Because how much of
It certainly will help the fact that we've played quite a few test matches here before, all of us, and we've scored runs. So I think that's even more important to know that you've performed in a certain place and you know how to get runs there. It's all about remembering those good things that we did and applying it here. I know England and South Africa were tougher. Australia, if the batsmen apply themselves, it can be a great place to bat as well. But it takes character, it takes you know, grinding out tough situations, because as I said, the Australian team has great skills, especially their bowling attack is really strong. So they will challenge us definitely a lot more. So we will just have to ride that that particular phase and then, you know, capitalize on the sessions that go our way. So I think as batsmen, we are looking forward to that opportunity, and purely because we need to step up as a batting group. We understand that the bowlers are in great you know, bowling form, as we all know. It's just a collective performance that needs to go in, and on a regular basis. It should not be one odd test match. So that's a challenge we're looking forward to.
Yeah. Have you decided your 11 tomorrow? And if you haven't, can you tell us what positions you're sort of tossing up? And sort of
we have the 12 ready. He'll be announcing after the press conference.
After the press conference, yeah.
It obviously has an impact. I mean, every side would like to have you know, fast bowling all-rounder, which we do not have right now with Hardik injured. So that's obviously a great sort of luxury to have for any side. We do not, so we'll have to go in with the best combination possible for us. Again, the workload on the guys who will play in absence of the all-rounder. The workload will be high, but that's something that, you know, already has been discussed, that they should look forward to that and not think of it as a burden or something which is going to be tough, because at international level things are tough. So we'll just have to embrace that and make something out of the resources that we have at present, and try to put in the performances that the team expects players to. So losing Hardik is obviously a bit of an issue, but I don't see that as a major issue, because in Australia, you know, you still have to bowl really well, even if you're an all-rounder, to contain batsmen, which is always a challenge. Sorry? He'll be announcing the 12, so I'm not going to talk about it now.
Last two. Yeah, Gaurav.
Just in recent times, India hasn't got off to the best start in the first test matches. In England, you touched on it, saying we need to play with a bit more freedom. Have you guys talked about it, and what's been the sort of, you know, the discussion about how to start better in that first test match?
Yes, for sure. I mean, we're not looking to start tentatively. I think we all want to express ourselves, go out there and be positive. Not meaning that we're going to play rash shots or, you know, we're going to be all over the place with the ball, but just in our heads, wanting to bring our A game in the first game itself, and then trying to lay a good foundation for us to capitalize on that as the series goes on. We don't want to wait to figure out what's happening with the conditions or the pitch. We got to read it really early and then, you know, alter our games accordingly, which I think we've failed to do in the last two tours. When we've done it, we've won games, but we'll have to do it for longer periods to be able to, you know, win a series, which is our goal. So we don't want to be a side that, you know, plays exciting cricket in one test match. We want to be a consistent side, and for that, I think we need to adapt quicker than we have in the past.
Do you change your plans according to the Australian team? They're not playing Mitchell Marsh, so they'll have Nathan Lyon there. If you can take Nathan Lyon down, you really change their plans. Would you go in with them?
Well, last time we played here, we had to sort of be positive against him, because, you know, he's such a good bowler, especially in these conditions. He understands the pace of the wicket, the bounce it's going to provide him, and, you know, where the fielders should be. He hits the bat harder and quicker than any other spinners that I've faced in Australia. So, look, it's you have to be at your best against, you know, guys like Nathan and their bowling attacks. So we're definitely not going to think too much about anyone, but we're not also not going to be, you know, tentative against anyone. We just have to back our game and make sure that we are confident of our skill set. And guys have to find ways of playing, you know, different bowlers accordingly. Some might want to sweep an off-spinner, some might not. So we'll just have to figure out our own game plans, as I said, adapt quickly and then see how the wicket's behaving and then, you know, find a way to score runs. We just don't want to stand out there and do nothing. You got to find ways to score runs if you want to win test matches.
Last two. Given what's happened with the Australian team this year, do you expect that sort of thing to happen as happens in Test series? Do you think that'll be too hard for them to, I guess, go away?
I personally don't think that, you know, any team should be totally negative after something like that happens. I don't see stuff happening which has happened in the past where both teams have crossed the line, but still you have to become, it's a competitive sport at the end of the day, it's international cricket. We do not expect guys to just, you know, come in and bowl and just walk back. Obviously, there are going to be times when you have to put the batsman under pressure, not necessarily crossing the line, but just get into their heads, which you expect from any side in the world, not just Australia. But so I think it is going to be there, but it's not going to be at the level that has happened in the past, where, you know, both teams have lost control. So, but the competitiveness will be there, because you eventually want to get guys out. If the situation is going your way and you understand you're up against an important guy in the opposition, you will go hard at that person, be it in your body language or just, you know, putting in a word or two. But I don't see anything radical happening, because the skill set is high, so we necessarily would not need to get into anything. But yeah, at times when situations are difficult, you do find ways to upset the batsman's rhythm, and I think a bit of banter there is not harmful at all.
Final one. Yes.
Virat, आप तो paper पढ़ते नहीं, लेकिन जो हम paper यहाँ पढ़ते हैं, आपके team में player एक विराट कोहली बोल के बस obsession है उसके बारे में, और कुछ लोग ये भी सोचते हैं कि बाकी batsman में दम नहीं है, ये दोनों चीजों की तरफ आप कैसे देखते हैं?
नहीं, मुझे ऑब्वियसली इस चीज़ पे मैं बिल्कुल भी विश्वास नहीं रखता हूँ, क्योंकि हमारे जितने भी बैट्समैन हैं उनके पास उतनी एबिलिटी है कि वो अकेले मैच को पलट सकते हैं, और उस चीज़ में मुझे 120% फेथ है और उनको भी अपनी एबिलिटी में फेथ है। तो बाहर लोग किस तरीके से किस चीज़ पे फोकस करते हैं वो हमारे कंट्रोल में नहीं है, और ना तो मैं किसी को मना कर सकता हूँ ना मैं बोल सकता हूँ कि करो। तो आई थिंक हम लोगों का सबका काम है कि फील्ड पे जाके परफॉर्मेंस देना, और अगर मैं कंट्रीब्यूट कर सकता हूँ तो मैं करूँगा, अगर और कोई बैट्समैन उस पोजीशन में कंट्रीब्यूट करने के तो वो करेंगे। बेसिकली गोल इंडियन टीम का होता है, और कोई क्या लिखता है या किस वजह से लिखता है वो हम लोग नहीं बोल सकते, क्योंकि हमने वो नहीं लिखा है वो चीज़। तो आई थिंक हमारा काम सिर्फ क्रिकेट पे फोकस करना है, बाकी इन चीज़ों से मुझे ऑनेस्टली कोई मतलब नहीं है।